This is what I saw on the set of Yellowstone season 2. And I spoke up. What myself and all the other crew members believed was a prop. We thought, wow, art department sure did a good job with this one. But as the sun came up and the temperature increased, we knew right away that it was not a prop. We knew that it was real. We began to smell the realness of this freshly dead carcass that had been mutilated in its hind quarters and in its neck, with flies and bees going in and out of the eyes, the nose, the nostrils, the mouth. It's terribly heartbreaking. And also seeing that the hind quarters and the neck had been mutilated and chopped up. And as crew members were wondering, why in the hell is this not a prop? Why in the hell, with the kind of $100 million budget, they would cut corners to line their pockets? We're not going to work to expose ourselves to potential biohazards. This open wound, dead carcass, and it carves something on your mind that you can never delete. And so there's a level of psychological torture for those of us that have a heart. On the evening of the rodeo scene, they made an announcement to the entire crew and all of the background. They said, we've had a recent incident, so we want to make sure that there are no cell phones and no cameras anywhere present or anywhere near the set. There were more scenes where more dead cattle carcasses were used. A week later, we were at a different location where they had about 6 or 7 dead cow carcasses that were bloated and laying on their sides. And another very long, hot day, swarms of flies and bees. Many weeks later, I'm walking down a hallway in the Park City Studios, and I see about 4 or 5 prop cattle. They looked absolutely realistic. Which makes you ask the question of why weren't these used in the first place? Why would you ever access a living animal, slaughtered or alive, a flesh animal, and use that when you have the budget and the means to have all of your things be props? I want audiences to know that this industry will hoodwink them unless they really dig down and realize the injustices that have been happening with animals. Anyone else in this industry like myself who witnesses abuse, dead animals, or neglect, and or any stomach-turning, heartless act that they see concerning animals, they need to speak up immediately.